Hey everybody, it's Gunnarola, and I'll be your host for the next 4 hours as we explore Zak's Haunted Museum in Las Vegas. We need you to be an active part of this investigation, so let us know what you see. You'll have access to 4 dedicated cameras in the space. First thing I want to know is where you're watching from. Let me know in the comments. I know that Ghost Adventures has fans all over the world. We have some fans outside waiting right now. Let us know where you're watching from in the comments, and I will see you during the commercial breaks.
There are things in this world that we will never fully understand.
Understand.
We want answers. So tonight, on Halloween, for the first time in nearly a decade, we're broadcasting live from my museum in Las Vegas, a building that is truly haunted.
I've been scratched.
I have this really ugly feeling.
I've had my hair pulled. I've been burned.
Get ready. Anything can happen. This is Ghost Adventures, the Haunted Museum, live.
Hey everybody, I'm Gunna Roll. I'm going to be watching the show with you tonight. I'll be back during the commercial breaks. Leave me all your comments. I'll see you soon. Hey, everybody, gonna roll it back. We are in a commercial. There are quite a few of you participating already, and it seems that there's already some activity being observed. If you see anything, make sure to let us know. I'd love to know where you're watching from, so let us know that as well. Some people saw some things happening in the fun house and in Peggy's room. We actually saw, we met some fans outside. They've been to this museum, and they've had their own experiences here. It's pretty wild to hear. If you have been to the museum, let me know. Let me know if you had any crazy experiences here. We'd love to hear about it. Hey everybody, how's it going? I'm Gunnar Rola. As I mentioned earlier, I'll be your host in the Social Command Center, which is where we are right now, looking at your comments, reading your tweets. If you are tweeting about the show, make sure to use the hashtag GhostAdventuresLive. Just looking at your comments right now, I gotta say, I think that Ghost Adventures has the most loyal, caring fan base. Do you guys think that?
Yes, absolutely.
Definitely. A lot of you are fearing for Zach and Co's safety here. Rachel says, I get the most awful feeling that someone or something is going around in the box. Don't get a good feeling from it at all. I did a walkthrough yesterday, and I did not even want to think or look or go near the Dybbuk Rocks room. It's pretty gross.
I did go in there.
Yeah. Did you feel anything?
Weird vibes, for sure.
Definite weird vibes. If you've been to the museum, let me know in the comments. We met some people outside who have been here. They've had their own experiences. You have access to 4 dedicated cameras live in the space right now. So we need your eyes. We need your ears. We need your nose. What are there other body parts, what other senses you might have? Let us know if you notice any activity. There is quite a bit of stuff going on already. I'm just going to read some more comments here. Victoria says, does anybody else see the weird shape or figure in the funhouse on the rug thing that a clown is leaning against? Or am I seeing things? Is Victoria seeing things? I don't know. I'm seeing a lot of things. If I take a look at that really carefully, funhouse vibes, I don't think that's a very fun place to be. We read some other comments here. Christina says, the horse in Peggy's room was moving a little. Did anybody see that? Let me know. Again, you've got access to 4 dedicated cameras in the space. Pay close attention over the next 4 hours. It's Halloween night. There is sure to be some interesting activity. I'll see you again during the next commercial break. Thank you. Alrighty, Gunnarola back here. That was pretty intense. You can see the guys in the oddities room, and already they're starting to feel stuff. And in the comments, rather, you are also starting to feel stuff. Tanya says that she's not kidding right now. My power just went out and came back on while watching the show, and the light strip behind it came on. So there's some weird stuff going on at home, it seems. Kayla, user Kayla 55069640 says, I'm worried for Zak now that there's a shadow figure in the dip room, and he's saying he can feel it. Zach's feeling some stuff. Let us know if you're feeling anything or if your power's going out. Kim just said, oh my god, I was wearing a crystal to protect myself while watching, and it just literally fell off my neck and broke. That's terrifying. That's terrifying. Hope just saw a light orb in the funhouse room. So if you're seeing any activity in one of these four feeds, let us know. You can see the guys right now. They're still in the oddities room. We're in a commercial break, and I'll see you during the next one. We are back. And the guys have split up. You can see them in the oddities room. We have a very creepy doll by the name of Lily. Reminiscent of another doll named
Annabelle.
Annabelle. If you guys remember that episode, Annabelle's Curse, we did get a comment from someone, Anella, who said Lily is as creepy as Annabelle. Do you agree? Let me know in the comments. I think all dolls are creepy. And if you go into that museum, there's quite a number of creepy dolls in there that you'll find. The guys split up. Is that a good idea?
You know, it's par for the course. I feel like this is what they do. And you know what? They know what they're doing. They know exactly what they're doing. They've done this so many times. But tonight is going to be especially terrifying. I feel it.
And the viewers at home can feel it too. There's a lot of interesting things happening with you guys. Cats. Do you have cats? Are your cats acting kind of strange? I read some comments about cats puking and cats hissing. That's why I don't own a cat.
And apparently, some people are commenting about how their computers are acting up just for unknown reasons. So is that happening to you?
Let us know. I think we had a weird audio-visual glitch. A lot of weird things happening tonight. It is Halloween, the perfect time to explore Zak's Haunted Museum in Las Vegas. Again, we're monitoring all of your comments. If you're going to tweet us, make sure to use the hashtag GhostAdventuresLive. It looks like we're trending, too. Is that true?
Number three,
and we've got over 36,000 viewers on this live stream. You have access to 4 dedicated cameras. You can see the guys in the oddities room right now. If you see anything, if you feel anything, let us know, and I'll see you again during the next commercial break. All right, Gunnarola back here. This is getting intense. Things are going haywire. Zach's equipment stopped working. What do you think that was about? Let us know in the comments. We can see the guys in the oddities room. That very creepy doll, Lily, just standing there. I can't watch that for too long. We were getting a lot of comments. Too many comments. We can barely keep up with them. Let me just read through a few of them here. Amanda says that the only thing she's noticing is in the Dybbuk box room are shadows. It keeps getting lighter and darker as if there's a moving shadow. Did anyone else see that? That is probably... It looks like the simplest room to me, but it definitely has the weirdest energy, I'd say. We're just staring at that box there. So if you're seeing anything in the Dybbuk box room, let us know. And we'll see if anything's going to happen with that tonight, if he's going to open that box up and what will happen. We're back to the broadcast. See you soon. Okay, we're back. That was strange. I don't know if you guys saw that at home, but we just cut to Zak really quickly, and we were not supposed to. So I don't think whatever energies, whatever spirits are here tonight are very happy with us. Again, we're seeing a lot of activity at home. Hey, we're back. Having a few technical difficulties. Not sure if you guys saw that, but Zak, we saw... Oh, we're back on TV. See you at the next break. All right, gonna roll it back here. That is intense. Zach's not feeling too good, it doesn't seem. And Dakota is, all of us right now, terrified. Let me read some of the comments that you've been leaving. Lori sees a shadow walking in the funhouse on the left. T. Harrison says, there's something happening with that second clown. At first, you could only see a portion of it, and now you can see almost the whole thing. I didn't notice that, but let me know if you did. The entire clown. From Twitter, we have a comment from Samuel. In the hallway with portraits, sounds like murmuring. Did anybody hear that? And Kate says, the mirror is affecting me at home. We've been hearing and seeing a lot of that from you guys tonight. Over the past hour, it seems that there are things happening in your home, with your furniture, with your electronics. There's stuff happening with our electronics over here. Your cats also don't seem too happy. Poor cats. Brittany says, does it look like there's a woman outside the door of the funhouse room? Anyone else see that? Kind of like nun attire. That's pretty creepy. And Stephanie says, guys, watch that doll in the wooden case. At first, its head looks tilted sideways, and then when you look at it again, it looks right at you. Very spooky. So you guys are doing some great investigative work. Let us know all the things that you see and observe at home. We can see the guys are still in the oddities room. That doll is still there, creeping me out. Are they just going to leave her on the floor like that? I hope not. I hope they put her back in her home because it's Halloween night. There's a lot of creepy things happening. We're going to go back to the show, but stay tuned. We might have some special guests. We'll see. We are back. It is getting super incredibly intense. We have a new character, Lady Snake. What do you guys think about Lady Snake? Good, bad?
I'm really excited to see her work with Dakota. Terrified, just because that's, I mean, you don't know what's going to happen.
And I can tell Dakota's pretty terrified. Poor guy. Let me read you some of these comments you guys have been leaving us. Seems like everybody's worried for the guys' safety, but especially Dakota. In terms of our feed here, we're seeing some activity all night. Anyone else see the face in the Dybbuk box? That's from Heather. Did anyone else see a face in the Dybbuk box? I'm looking at it right now. I don't see it, but if you see it, let me know. From Twitter, the camera moved twice in the Dybbuk box room. Did no one else see that? Did you see it?
I didn't see it.
There's so much going on in here. I forgot to introduce our team. We have Megan and Ronnie. These two are in charge of our a lot of things, but tonight our social media feed. So they're the ones who get to read all your comments and tweets. How are you guys feeling?
There's a lot of comments coming in. The fans are always doing an amazing job, but tonight you guys are on fire helping out with the investigation. And seriously, I mean, we're sending notes back, letting them know what everyone is seeing. So please keep your comments coming.
Super on it. We might have some guests come in here tonight. Might have some more unexpected surprises. I don't know. We'll have to find out. See you soon.
Thank you.
We're back. It's getting wild in here. I know I keep saying that after every break, but it truly is. We have Patty coming face to face with the Lady Snake. What did you guys think of that? Let me know in the comments. Aaron, I don't know if you noticed him, but I think Aaron was all of us, pretty terrified, ready to get out of there. I don't know why he keeps doing this, but we appreciate it, Aaron. If I take a look at some of the comments you guys have been leaving for us here, it looks like a lot of you are feeling things at home. Les says, TT says, I just got a stabbing pain in my side. Anyone else experience any pain when Zak laid down in the center of Lady Snake's diagram? Did you feel that? It definitely is getting cold out here, and I don't know what's going on. We'll take a look at some other comments as we go on. Let us know also if you're on Twitter, use the hashtag GhostAdventuresLive. And let us know what you see. We do appreciate that you're keeping an eye on these four dedicated cameras while the guys are in the basement. So we've got the Dybbuk box room, the oddities room, Peggy's room, and the fun house. Let us know if you see anything. It looks like we're detecting a lot of activity and shadows. Keep leaving us those comments. We'll see you at the next break. All right, we're back. Gonna roll here. Ghost Adventures Live. You're interacting with you on Facebook. We're keeping an eye on these four cameras. Let me read you some comments and let me know if you agree with them. Heather saw a white shadow in the back behind the box, and she's also concerned for Zach's safety. She says she gets a funny feeling about it. Brian Metheny says the camera in the Divic box room keeps focusing in and out. That's a little bit of us. That's not too, I don't think that's too supernatural there. That's just us getting the best shot possible. Amanda says, I had to stop watching the Divic box room and I had to stop. I had pain in my neck and shoulder. It went away, but I'm drawn to watch there again. Call me crazy. I don't think you're crazy. I think this stuff is very, very alluring and powerful in its own way. Felicia says, I'm looking at the Dybbuk box room, and it seems like something is in there. I have a headache and feel sick. Don't open that box. Do you agree with Felicia? Should we leave well enough alone? Should we leave that box there, or should we open it up? Let us know in the comments. From Twitter, we have some comments as well. Harmony Page heard a noise, and she wants to know what Aaron heard in the basement. There's another comment from Titan Cross 24. It says, Dakota, possibly the new Aaron. Maybe the new bait, sending him out on missions by himself. I think I definitely relate to Dakota and Aaron. I don't think I could do this alone. I don't know how they do it, but it's got to be done, and we're thankful that they're doing that. What do you guys feel about Dakota? Are you more Dakota? Are you a Zach? Are you an Aaron? Is there a quiz they could take to find out? I don't know. Let me know in the comments below who you relate most to. Patricia says, I had to take a Xanax while watching The Two Witches. My chest got tight, and I felt like I was having a panic attack. I think we were all pretty tense. It was pretty tense in the social command center here. It's always a little tricky when two personalities come together that we know maybe don't like each other. But we didn't see a brawl tonight, but definitely not a lot of positive energy there. If we look at more comments here, we've got one from Captain Loco. When the White Witch finished her protection spell, there was a ball lightning effect. It was clear as day to me. No wonder Zach jumped a mile high. I think we were all pretty surprised when they jumped. Let me know what you thought in the comments. We're reading through more of these. Again, you guys are keeping an eye on the Dybbuk box room, the oddities room, where that doll now, I think, is back in her home, Lily. Peggy's room. I didn't see any comments about Peggy's room. I haven't seen any comments lately, but there was a lot of activity off the top of our show. And we have the fun house as well. Some pretty creepy characters there. We did see some activity. Let us know if you see anything. Pay close attention to those feeds. You are such a part of this experience. We really appreciate you helping us out. And it's pretty cool that technology allows us to all watch this together, no matter where we are in the world. Let me know where you are in the world. I met some viewers earlier today who drove from Phoenix, Arizona, all the way to Las Vegas. And yeah, let me know where you're watching from. Let's do a little roll call here. Do we have any international viewers? Anybody outside of the U.S. watching? Let me know. A lot of your cats, too. Your poor cats seem terrified. Maybe because it's Halloween, but maybe because they also sense some strange activity emanating from your screens. Cats and animals always seem to know. Jody's cat was in a dead sleep, and when the two witches were talking, then he jumped straight up in the air, meowing loudly after she finished. Holy moly. That's pretty tough. You know, it might be a good idea to leave your cats in another room. We don't want to terrorize the poor cats. So yeah, keep commenting, tweet to us with the hashtag Ghost Adventures Live, and we'll see you at the next break.
Just walking up to the house, you started to feel it. Then going down the hall, then something ran past me. And then going down those stairs and seeing her there, I was just like hit with a wall. She's doing very bad things in there.
Lady Snake, tell us about our viewers at home. All the fans were very concerned. They felt nauseous, anxious. Like, what were you? What was going through your head?
I was nauseous. I was anxious. But I was trying to put on a brave face. I was, because I believe light beaks dark. When I said that, I believe you bring a candle into the room, it brings in light. Yes, you see all the shadows. You see the scary darkness. But the fact, I really did want to stay there, scared to death. But she's, it's just, I saw she was bringing something very dark. I couldn't even put words to what it was. And glib about it. And then she was, what I think she was trying to do that. What is that thing when you try to look over here and you do something over here, calling me like disrespectful or something, which had nothing to do with that. It was all, it was like, I don't know what you call that thing when you try to look over here and do that.
Yeah, like distraction.
Yeah, distraction. She was doing a distraction about being polite versus what she's doing, this opening a dark hole in a pentagram to bring in evil because she has Zach's permission. Well, I have Zach's permission too.
Right. So some pretty sinister intentions.
Oh, she has very sinister intentions.
Okay. Now you mentioned also October 31st, a very special day for witches. Can you tell me about that?
Yes, it's Samhain. It is our New Year's. It actually is the day when the veil between the worlds is the thinnest. That is actually why people dress up for Halloween. They put on masks to keep from the scary animals and the ghosts that are coming in. That's why even in old Europe, they would put jack-o'-lanterns by the gate. They were turnips where we use pumpkins to scare away dark spirits. This is the night when spirits good and bad come through. And the good side of things in Samhain and the pagan, we celebrate the dead. We celebrate our ancestors, beautiful altars, just like Dia de los Muertos in the Mexican tradition. So that's what it's all about, celebrating the dead. But the veil is thin, so it's like a big wide open door that all sorts of stuff can come through, good and bad.
And if you're just joining us, we're here with Patty Negri. Yeah. We're about to open something, the Dybbuk box. What do you think is going to happen with that?
Oh my gosh. I don't know. Zach can handle it. And I must say, the fact everybody he brought in, Chris Fleming, Michael and Marty Perry, all these experts, he surrounded himself with the best in the business of people to know what they're doing. I'll be out here going, doing my...
We all will. We'll be scared. We'll be scared.
It. But I think he's going to do it. Tonight's the night to do it because, again, it is a holy day. It's a sacred day, the veil thin day, and he's surrounded by the best of the best. He's got Dave. He's got everybody who knows what they're doing. He's got Gary. He's got Joshua. It's amazing. So if he's going to do it, he should do it now, and I'm equally worried about what Lady Snake's doing.
Brought the whole crew. Last question. Any messages for your fans watching?
Don't try this at home by yourself. But if you like this world, it's a great world to get into. Just be careful what you do and who you invite in and know what you're doing. Learn. Study.
Leave it to the professionals. We are going to cut to fix. Thank you so much for joining us. We're going to fix our feed, so stay tuned. Refresh the Facebook page. We'll see you in a bit.